Aloha, one and all, and thank you very much for joining us for this edition of Five Questions, broadcast right here on KHVH Radio, also appearing at khvhradio.com, and of course, with hawaiireporter.com, where you can log on 24/7 for the very best in news and information. It is a delight to have a chat with Mr. Bill Gertz. Bill has been a guest on our program in the past. He, of course, national security editor. He is also a columnist with Inside the Ring with the Washington Times. A prolific author. We'll chat about some of his work in a moment. But, Bill, aloha to you. Thanks for being with us.
Hey, great to be on the show.
You know, Bill, national security is always top of mind with us here in Hawaii, I think just out of a sense of history and geography. But I want to kind of go globally with you with our first question, if you don't mind.
Sure.
What is your assessment of our global condition regarding peace and security?
Okay. Basically, the way I see things now is some tremendous gains have been made at the number one national security threat, which is Islamist extremism in general and al-Qaeda in particular. Clearly, the capture and killing of Osama bin Laden was a major breakthrough in the war on terrorism. That said, al-Qaeda still remains dangerous, and we see the proliferation of a number of al-Qaeda-linked groups, one of which, most alarmingly, is gaining ground in Yemen. Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula is threatening the strategic port city of Aden. And, you know, if they get control of a portion of a country, they could begin to set up more bases from which to attack us again. So that's a real problem. And I would say that the second problem about is China's emergence as a global strategic power that is seeking to push the United States out of Asia.
I mean, literally push the U.S. presence out, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah. You have written extensively, this great segue into question number two, you've written extensively about China. So when you talk about an emerging China, what is the true relationship between the United States and China in this scenario, and what's the implication if they're successful in whatever their objectives are?
China is on the march ideologically, economically, diplomatically, militarily. They're becoming more assertive and more aggressive, especially in Asia. And they're exploiting the fact that the U.S. has been weakened by the financial crisis, and we're facing a host of domestic economic problems. This is feeding China's false notion that the U.S. is a declining power. A lot of observers think that this could lead to some type of a miscalculation on the part of the Chinese, especially as it relates to some of the hotspots like Taiwan or taking some type of military action against Taiwan that could involve us in a conflict there. There's a lot of concerns about that. The relationship, unfortunately, is not getting better. We saw recently the visit to China by the chairman of the Joint Chiefs, Admiral Mike Mullen, at which point the Chinese Chief of Staff, General Chen Bingde, basically criticized him, criticized the U.S. for conducting military exercises with our allies and friends in the region. And this was a fairly startling assertion by the Chinese general, and it's a sign that despite efforts to try and improve relations or build trust between the militaries, there's a big gap there.
Wasn't there a point in time, and I recall here, Bill, just as a sidebar, that during military exercises, I mean, China was participating side by side with us. We were sharing some, if not technological, at least strategic operational information together. I mean, has that soured completely now?
Well, we really haven't done very much with the Chinese, despite approaches to them to do some things. Military has tried to engage them in some joint exercises. The Chinese, remain a nuclear-armed communist dictatorship, and they unfortunately view the United States as their main enemy. They won't engage us on real issues like cyber threats, cyber attacks, their nuclear forces, their space weapons. They don't want to talk about those things with us, and that's a real problem. It's definitely a big problem.
We're talking with Bill Gertz, and we're delighted that Bill is with us today on this edition of Five Questions. Bill, before we continue the questions, tell us a little bit about the Gertz file.
Gertz file is my website where if you go to www.gertzfile.com, I post my stories there. I also have information about my books. It's a good one-stop shop for national security news.
And The Failure Factory, the latest effort, right?
Yeah, that was my 2008 book. It's still relevant today. I mean, they're still discussing it even in today's newspapers. There are stories about I reported on how the U.S. government bureaucracy is out of control and specifically highlighted the problem of Iran's nuclear program, where our intelligence community issued this estimate in 2007 that said that their nuclear program had been halted. And the fact of the matter is their nuclear weapons program is moving ahead apace, and yet our intelligence people continue to have a kind of head-in-the-sand attitude to that.
I know this is five questions, so I won't treat this as a question, more as an inquiry. But you are apprised of so much that the average American is not. You must have a perspective on our world condition clearly that we're just not privy to. How do you process this? And as an American, does it have an effect on you as to what our world condition truly is?
No, I think I play an important role, as the press does in general, of informing people. You know, I mean, my view is that if people, and I'm talking about the general public, if they don't understand clearly the threats that are out there, the threats that we as a nation and as a world are facing, then there's not an impetus to take steps to try and deal with those threats, whether it's through military or intelligence action or diplomacy or anyway. So the press, in my view, it really plays an important role in informing and educating the public about the problems and the threats facing us in the world.
We are involved with five questions with Bill Gertz, of course, national security editor, columnist inside the ring for The Washington Times. What's your role, Bill, or I'm sorry, your assessment of Hawaii's role in national defense? And are we, Hawaii, a fortified community, not impervious, but perhaps Teflon to terrorism, or are we a vulnerable target?
Clearly, I think because Hawaii sits in such a strategic location in the center of the Pacific Ocean, and with the problem of a rising China, Hawaii's role in national defense and international security is increasing. Clearly, there have been steps taken in recent years to fortify U.S. military forces in the Pacific. We haven't seen any large-scale shifts. We've moved a carrier. We've moved some submarines. We're fortifying Guam. We're doing some kind of software-type security elements to strengthen our alliances in the region. And this is all, you know, they kind of couch it as saying in case we need to respond to a conflict in Korea or even a contingency in Iran, but it's really based on China. And as for terrorism, yeah, clearly because of that, nobody's impervious to terrorist threats. Obviously, you have to be vigilant in Hawaii to any kind of terrorist attack. We know that Al-Qaeda has said they're going after us, and we've got to be vigilant in all the states.
That leads us to question number four. One of the most disconcerting scenarios you actually alluded to earlier, but specifically would be a nuclear weaponized Iran.
Yeah.
And please, go ahead.
Sure. I mean, this is a huge problem. I mean, we have a terrorist sponsoring regime in Tehran that is rapidly building nuclear weapons, despite bureaucratic resistance to accepting that assessment. And you have a situation where the head of Iran has said it wants to wipe Israel off the face of the earth, and that has increased instability in the entire Middle East, because when you have a country like Iran, which already has large numbers of ballistic missiles that can reach targets as far away as Europe and is working to build a small warhead, nuclear warhead for those missiles, that creates a real tense situation, because what it does is it puts in the calculation of the Israelis, do we sit back and wait for the Iranians to get a nuclear weapon since their leader has said they're going to wipe them off the face of the earth, or do we preempt? And so that's why you have a very unstable situation with Iran's nuclear weapon.
For those of us who would like to find the Failure Factory, I noticed on your website that it's in paperback and available at bookstores everywhere, yeah?
Yes, it is. It's also online.
Perfect.
Or through my website, too.
And just order it right there, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Bill, we're at question number five. And again, as a journalist, just how open is our government regarding national security? And in your mind, what's the most underreported story that has the greatest potential impact to America?
Okay, good questions. The first is our government is the most open in the world, and that there's a reason for that. You know, the founding fathers were skeptical of central government, so they created three branches, and then they went even a step further and said, look, we're going to have a free press that's going to provide an additional check on those other three branches. So in my experience as, you know, as a reporter at the Washington Times for 26 years, mm-hmm. the press plays a vital role in providing a check on government and also educating and informing people, as I mentioned earlier. I think the most underreported story with the greatest potential impact is the problem of communist China and the failure to understand the real motives, the use of strategic deception by Beijing about what they're doing and what they want to do. It's been a kind of a cause of mine as a reporter for at least a decade to try and highlight the military buildup of China as well as the ideological doctrine and motives behind that buildup, which to me I think is the most underreported story and one with the greatest potential security impact on our country.
An amazing conversation. A lot of ground covered. We'd love to have you come back to Hawaii. Any plans to come back out soon?
Well, there's a lacrosse tournament coming up in the fall. I may try to make that, and perhaps we can talk again.
I'd be delighted. Bill, thanks so very much. I urge our friends to go to www.gertzfile.com. You'll find the Failure Factory there. You can always log on and keep up with Bill on his site at gertzfile.com. Hey, Bill, thanks so very much. I hope we do see each other soon.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thanks. Aloha. Bye now.